I got a surprise review for you. Well, it's not really a surprise. You see the title down below the video, and you know what it is. Anyway, 7 years ago, I talked about the Wiz for about 10 minutes, but this was 7 years ago. We're talking about almost a decade ago. I want to talk about this little device again, because this device is absolutely wonderful. It's a Linux-based handheld device that came out about 7 to 8 years ago. And I'm going to compare this to modern devices, which are doing kind of the same thing and are in handheld form. The reason I want to do that is because I still think this is viable and has a lot of great features, and I'll explain why. First up, it's Linux-based and has a whole software development kit available for it, which means you don't have to really hack around to make something for it. The kit's right there. Also, most of the emulators you may want to use already exist on this. Now, there hasn't been any real new development for software for these. It's been ages, really. I mean, the thing's almost 10 years old. It's getting a little long in the tooth. However, that doesn't mean it's dead. In my case, after finding this, because I lost it, and I found it yesterday, it still holds a charge, which is amazing. Lithium-ion battery that has drained really bad is still holding a charge? What? Seriously. But there's not just that. Okay, it's a small device, which is perfect, which means I can put it in a shirt pocket. It fits in a shirt pocket. Seriously. Who doesn't want a device that is that small? It has several accessories. It's got built-in stereo speakers, but we'll talk about that in a bit. There is a flaw with it. But it has two shoulder buttons. You got your D-pad, and you got four buttons over here. Menu and select, and menu usually acts like a start button in emulators. And my favorite, the OLED screen. This is the most brightest screen I have ever seen. I mean, I'm holding it really, really close just to get my webcam to underexpose a little bit here. And it's still too bright. It's really good. Now, there's only one emulator, though, that V-syncs properly, and I know this is a thing, you know, performance issues. Even modern devices have performance issues with these. However, Pico Drive, the smoothest emulation I have ever seen on this device. I mean, it is a smooth emulation. You would think you're playing it on basically real hardware and not an emulator. It's that good. What's also interesting is the OLED can actually change its refresh rate. So when you play PAL or NTSC region games, they play at their proper speeds, but it's still smooth because the OLED basically changed refresh rates. Now let's talk about the flaws. The main flaw that I find with this device is sound. If you put in headphones and listen to something that has like perfect stereo separation, you're going to find an interesting quirk. The left channel plays both left and right channel. But the right channel plays only right channel. It's really, really weird. And when I actually checked it on the speakers themselves, it's flipped. The issue is backwards. That's really, really weird. And it seemed that someone was trying to really determine what causes it. I guess they said that a diode on the main board might be installed backwards. Possible? Nothing came of it. I actually have two of these. The other one had the same exact problem. So it's not like just a flaw. Maybe something was wrong with the one that was sent to me. Both of them have the problem, so it's a production problem. But, you know, there's one really good feature about this that a lot of the new devices just don't do. Some of them are starting to have this, but removable batteries. Okay? And this isn't like a small battery. It's 1900 milliamps an hour. 3.7 volts, it's lithium. I mean, at 3.7 volts, it better be lithium. But 1900 milliamps an hour. These things can last a pretty decent amount of time. Now, granted, you're limited to, you know, it's an older CPU, so it's going to use a little bit more power, and especially if you're using an emulator, we're going through a lot. The CPU on this, on the Wiz, is 533 megahertz. You can overclock it, though, to 900 megahertz. Now, that overclocking to 900 megahertz is not always stable. I find on my device 733 megahertz is the highest I can go without it starting to have spaz attacks. But, you know, the way I see it, downclock it. Some of these emulators work just fine. You can downclock like the Sega Genesis emulator, because Genesis emulation is perfect on this device. That includes Master System and Sega CD. 32X, on the other hand, no. Sega 32X emulation is just pitiful on it. But what do you expect? I mean, the 32X is a very complex piece of hardware. I mean, I remember having to use a Pentium 3 to do it. Anyway, I'm going to wrap up this little quick review. I think the device is fantastic. I really think if you can still get these, get them. If not, buy one used. Word of warning, though. If someone says that the screen has a problem, don't get it, because some OLED batches had problems where it got black blotches on them and started basically deteriorating the entire screen to nothing. You don't want one of those simply because it's not repairable. OLED is an organic light-emitting diode, and when they say organic, they're not lying. It developed a virus, like a flu. Anyway, Genesis Games, Shadow of the Beast. Oh. It does get pretty loud. Some people complain that these devices, the Wiz, is not very loud, but I think it really depends on your emulator, because this thing gets pretty loud to me. Anyway, YouTube, have a good one. I hope this little review kind of explains some things, and, you know, get a Wiz. They're fun. Have a good one.